गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. टुडे वी आर लर्न अबाउट द लाइफ लोड रिलेशनशिप. ओके, व्हाट इज द इक्वेशन फॉर द लाइफ लोड रिलेशनशिप इज दैट वी आर लर्न अबाउट. ओके, सो इन दिस बीट वी जस्ट वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वॉट दैट इज L10. व्हाट इज L10? वी नो दैट. व्हाट इज L10? It is a rated bearing life. Okay, L10 is a rated bearing life. Okay, so what in this beat A also we want to calculate. What is A? A is a constant and which is having the value 3 in ball bearing. Okay, and which is having the value of 10/3 in for roller bearing. Okay guys, okay. In next the formula for the life load relationship is that is L10 is equal to L of N10 into N into 60 divided by 10^6. This is the formula for calculating the life load relationship. Okay, so in this we know about the parameters of this formula, that is N is a bearing speed in RPM. Okay, next is L of N10. What is L of N10? It is a rating life of bearing in hours. Okay, and in this the speed should be constant. Okay, next is L10. We know that is a rating life of the bearing. Okay, so in this way we are calculating the L10 with the help of this formula or life load relationship is that the L10 is directly proportional to the L of N10. Okay, so this is the directly proportional to the concept. Okay, so what is L10? It is the rating life. And what is L of N10? It is the rating life of the bearing in hours. Okay, so L10 is directly proportional to the L of N10. That is the rating life of the bearing is directly proportional to the rating life of the bearing in hours at constant speed. Okay. Now in this we want to calculate about the basic statistics load rating, that is CO. Okay, so we have the formula for it. What is the formula for CO? Is equal to F of 0 into N into Z into D^2 cos of alpha. This is the formula for calculating the statics load rating. Okay, okay. In this, whereas what is CO? It is the statics load rating. Okay, what is F0? Is the factor which will be depend upon the type of bearing. Okay, so the value is 3.33 is for what? The self align बॉल बेयरिंग, ओके, विच इज सेल्फ अलाउइंग बॉल बेयरिंग, ठीक है. एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ 12.3 इज फॉर व्हाट? द रेडी, इट इज फॉर रेडियल कॉन्टैक्ट एंड द एंगुलर कॉन्टैक्ट. एंगुलर कॉन्टैक्ट ग्रू बॉल बेयरिंग, ठीक है. सो दिस इज द वैल्यू फॉर F0 3.33 फॉर सेल्फ अलाइन बॉल बेयरिंग एंड 12.3 इज फॉर द रेडियल एंड द एंगुलर कॉन्टैक्ट ग्रू बॉल बेयरिंग, ओके. नेक्स्ट इज द स्मॉल n. व्हाट इज स्मॉल n? इट इज द नंबर ऑफ रोज, इट इज नंबर ऑफ रोज ऑफ बॉल्स इन एनी बेयरिंग, इन एनी बेयरिंग, ओके. सो नेक्स्ट इज अ जेड, जेड, ठीक है. इट इज अ नंबर ऑफ बॉल पर रो, ओके. व्हाट इज यन? इट इज अ नंबर ऑफ रोज ऑफ बॉल्स इन एनी बेयरिंग. इफ वी आर टेकिंग एनी बेयरिंग एंड having the two numbers of rows, three numbers of rows, so value of n is that, okay, two or three. And what is z? It is the number of balls per row, as per row, okay. So don't confuse in it. So what is d? What is d? D is the diameter of, d is the diameter of ball in which mm, ठीक है. And what is alpha? What is alpha? So alpha is the nominal angle, nominal angle of contact, okay. So this is the concept for static load rating. So in this formula we want to calculate the CO, that is static. Our next bit is a static equivalent, static equivalent load, okay. So what is static equivalent load? So it is defined as, static equivalent load, it is defined as the radial load, the radial load in which will causes the same total permanent deformation, total permanent deformation on a ball, ठीक है. And recess as that under the actual load, okay. So simply, a static equivalent load is defined as, it is a radial load, whereas a radial load which will causes the same total permanent deformation of a ball and recess as that under the actual load conditions, okay. So static equivalent load is defined, ठीक है. So how to calculate the static load, which is denoted by P, S, okay. So X A F R plus Y of static, into F of A, okay. So simply, what is PS is the static load, static equivalent load, ओके. व्हाट इज एफ आर? एफ आर इज द रेडियल लोड. व्हाट इज इट इज द रेडियल लोड. ओके. व्हाट इज एफ ए? इट इज एक्सियल, एक्सियल और विच इज ऑल्सो अ थर्स्ट लोड. ओके. नेक्स्ट इज वाई? यस इज द थर्स्ट लोड फैक्टर. ओके. एंड अनदर लास्ट वन इज द एक्स एस इज द रेडियल लोड फैक्टर. ओके. ओके. इन दिस टर्म रिमेंबर दैट इन दिस टर्म the xa xs and ys which will depend on the type of bearing which are the selected from the manufacturing catalog. With the help of catalog we can select the bearing type and in which the xs any ys is will be depend. Okay. So static equivalent load will be calculated with the help of this formula. Okay. So the next is the equivalent dynamic load. Okay. So how to calculate the equivalent dynamic load, which is denoted by P of E. Okay. So it is defined as the constant stationary radial load. It is defined as the constant stationary radial load which if applied to a bearing with rotating inner ring, when applied to bearing with rotating inner ring and stationary outer ring. Okay, outer ring, which will give the same bearing life to the applied combined load. Okay, so equivalent dynamic load is defined as the constant stationary radial load which will be applied if the bearing with rotating inner ring and stationary outer ring will give the same bearing life as the applied combined load. Okay, so this will be definition for the equivalent dynamic load, and which will be calculated with the formula P of E is equal to X V F R plus y of f a into k a. Okay, where what is PE? That is equivalent dynamic load. Okay, which will be equivalent dynamic load and which will be in a newton. Okay, what is FR? We know that. What is it? Radial load. What is FA? which is axial load. What is x and what is y? X is a radial factor, always. Okay, radial factor, and which will be y? Thrust factor. Okay, what is y? What is y? Y is the thrust factor and the x is the radial factor. Okay, next is v. V is the rotation factor, remember it, rotation factor. Okay, and what is ka? We know that. What is it? Application factor. What is ka? Application factor. Okay, the value of application factor is changes according to its conditions. Okay, 1.0 is for inner race, which is 1.2 for outer race, and which is exactly 1 for self align. Okay, remember that in this, what is in this? X, Y and V, the values of X, Y and V are given in a manufacturing handbook. Okay, so we want to calculate it with this formula is FR, FA, KA, and with the help of this all parameters we can calculate the equivalent dynamic load. Okay, so with the help of this formula we can calculate the equivalent dynamic load. Okay, so thank you very much.